Hello everyone, Adam here. Today, electronic do-it-yourself episode, and we're gonna be making two-way packet radio communicator, off-grid communicator, so something that will work without any kind of cellular network and something that will allow you to send encrypted communication, something that no one can intercept, no one will hear, no one will see. And what is composed of? It is composed of CC1101 board and Arduino board. This one in my design is Atmega 32U, 8 MHz 3.3 volts based, and USB. Actually, this micro USB, because Arduino has one micro USB to USB, and an adapter to USB-C. This is for my smartphone, which will be one side of the communication. And second unit, which is made exactly same way, but it is with the USB at the end, and this will be connected to the PC. Okay, so let's get started. When device is connected to the terminals, it looks like this. So one terminal is actually my smartphone connected over USB-C cable to the USB to micro USB, and then Arduino board, and then CC1101. On the other side, there is also the same kind of unit that is connected to the HP laptop, and as you can see, goes right here through the USB to my PC. Okay, now it's time to show you the code and what you can do with this device. Okay, all the details of this project I have put here on my GitHub. It is this address. Right here you can also find the wiring diagram, which is here. You need to connect, actually 8 pins needs to be connected between CC1101 board and Arduino board. Along with these settings, you will need also to interconnect power lines like VCC and GND. And as you can see, I'm using this SmartRC library. On this site, you can also find wiring information for other boards like Arduino Pro, Arduino Nano, Arduino Mega, and other. If you scroll down below, I would also encourage you to download the most recent version of the library, which is right here. However, I have included some older one, which also works with my design right here on my page. And going further, if you have programmed and connected, you may want to see on which serial port it operates. It will use a virtual serial port. In my case, it is port number 4. And this port you need to select in the PATI, so in the application for the hyper terminal. I have pre-configured something, but I probably need to change the port number. Okay, and if I now try to send anything, it should appear on the screen of the mobile phone. However, I need to first enable application to this. As you can see, serial USB terminal is the application that we'll be using. And first letter that I have sent is already here. Let me send something in the opposite side. Hello. And as you can see, it appeared on the PC screen. This is my packet radio off-grid communication device. As you can see, all appears here on the screen of the smartphone. The range, it will really depend on the boards that you have, on the CC1101 boards, and if this board has a proper antenna. As you can see, the communication is half duplex, so we can send and receive, but not at the very same moment. This is the smartphone. And more, you can have plenty of these devices connected to the same channel. this is channel number one. Okay, so that's pretty all for this. I hope you like this device. You can play with the settings, and if you look into my source code, on the beginning there's information about the library that was attached, but down below there's a plenty of settings that you can play with. For example, the frequency here, the modulation type. It is right now operating on the GFSK, but you can change anything. You can change the channel number and all the details, as well as the transmission power and data rate. You can play with this to achieve the best communication range that that is achievable. So it's up to you to play with it, to set everything. Ah, yeah, one more thing. If you are using different bots, you may want to change these settings, because I have set them to match with this Arduino Pro Micro bot that I have shown. Okay, guys, I hope you you enjoyed this little video. If you have some questions, just please drop down below them, and I will be able to answer maybe in some free time. And see you next time. Please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.